We're very fortunate to have a guest on this evening. He's one of the great American songwriters, Mr. James Taylor. Very nice to have you on the show, James. And before you're going to be doing some numbers shortly, but before that, there's the routine inquiries that we have to go through here at the piano. Now, for instance, Caleb had a musical family. Was your family musical?
Yeah, I guess you'd have to say it was. Yeah.
What did you start off listening to?
Well, mostly just whatever was on the radio in North Carolina where we lived, which is mostly sort of country music, and also what my folks would play around the house. You know, they had one of those. There was typically a big stack of vinyl on top of that little spindle, you know, then dropping down over the period of the over the day, you know, through the day.
A bit of a crackle, and then what record would you hear?
Well, they played a lot of show tunes and also sort of folk music of various sorts, Woody Guthrie and Lead Belly and that sort of thing.
And you came to Britain and made your first record for Apple. I think that's right, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Which of the Beatles signed you?
Well, actually, Peter Asher, who has been my manager and produced probably most of my records over the years, he had just started working for Apple Records when I started shopping my demos around here in London in 1968. So it was he who heard it and played it for Paul McCartney and George Harrison, and I think they gave it the stamp of approval and it was off.
Now,
it was great.
Your album Sweet Baby James was a vast hit around the world. Was that a surprise to you?
A very, very pleasant surprise, yeah. No.
Now, we've got some footage of you from that era, right here at the British Broadcasting Corporation. And our routine inquiries are going to show it just on the screen here.
To the highway, won't you lend me your name? Your way and my way, they seem to be one and the same. Mama don't understand it, she wants to know where I've been. I have to be some kind of not-so-born fool to pass that way again. But you know I could feel it. Walking on a country road.
Is it my imagination, or was that Carole King playing the piano?
Yeah, that would have been Carole, yeah.
Good pianist to take around with you. Do you still see Carole?
Occasionally, yeah, I do. That was refreshing.
We love that.
Oh, good.
How did you feel about that man, looking at that man now? You like him? I think he's great.
He's very relaxed.
Yeah.
Very laid back.
And the bass player, just who was he? He had the biggest beard that I've ever seen.
That's right. You know, I asked his wife what he looked like without that beard, and she said she had never seen him without a beard. And it turns out that his mother has never seen him without a beard.
Excellent. Now,
that's Lee Sklar. That was, and I suppose still is, Lee Sklar.